As an advanced medical practitioner and pharmacist practicing in family medicine, I am always shocked at how many patients and even some medical providers have blood pressure monitors that are actually inaccurate. So here's what we're going to do. In this week's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 7 of my top tips to make sure that you have the most accurate blood pressure monitor, most accurate blood pressure readings from your monitor. So let's begin. So let's dive straight into tip number 1. And it is critical to make sure that the blood pressure monitor that you are using is on what we call the validated device list, which we call VDL for short. Unfortunately, many of the blood pressure monitors that are available on online retailers like Amazon, for example, are not on the VDL list. This basically means that the blood pressure monitors have not gone through rigorous testing, so formal studies, to prove and show that they are giving accurate blood pressure readings. So if a blood pressure monitor is unvalidated, so it's not on the VDL list, there's no knowing how accurate it actually is, and it may be giving you inaccurate blood pressure readings. So I guess the next question is, how serious can it be if you're not getting the most accurate blood pressure readings? So I want to explain this one with a bit of a patient story. I had a patient, middle-aged, who was submitting 7 days of home blood pressure readings, and they were using their home blood pressure monitor. He was actually using a blood pressure monitor that wasn't on the VDL list, so it was unvalidated, and his blood pressure readings were high. I didn't know at the time his blood pressure monitor was unvalidated, but when he came into the office for our appointment and he brought his blood pressure monitor in, I was then able to look up if it was validated and on the VDL list. And the only reason this really crossed my mind was when I looked at his blood pressure monitor, I'd never heard of the brand, okay? So we searched it up and it wasn't on the VDL list. And in fact, when I was taking his blood pressure reading in clinic, his readings were normal. So what did we do? We actually loaned him a blood pressure monitor, one of our A&D medical monitors actually that we have in my medical practice that I work at. He took it home and resubmitted 7 days of home blood pressure readings, and they were all normal. Basically, what this could have meant for that patient is, one, an incorrect hypertension diagnosis. Hypertension is a medical word for high blood pressure. And two, potentially me starting him on antihypertensive medication, so high blood pressure medication, when he probably didn't need it. So by using a device that isn't on the VDL list, it can be very dangerous for your own health. Now it's time for the good news, because all of our A&D medical blood pressure monitors are validated, they're on the VDL list. So they're validated by organizations like the American Medical Association, Hypertension Canada, and the British or Irish Hypertension Society. So basically, if you're using an A&D medical blood pressure monitor and you're watching this video right now, you've got nothing to worry about validated devices. And just in case you guys aren't aware of this, I always love to tell people this in our videos and my friends and family that I know as well. Here at A&D Medical, we actually invented the digital home blood pressure monitor back in 1977. So when it comes to blood pressure and accuracy, we're a brand that you know you can trust. Moving straight on to tip number 2, let's talk about your blood pressure cuff. This is probably one of the most common mistakes I see patients making when they have a blood pressure monitor. Studies have shown that using a blood pressure cuff that's too small for you can actually overestimate your blood pressure by about 5 to 20 millimeters of mercury, and that is quite a significant overestimation. And also remember that using a cuff that's too big for you can basically underestimate your blood pressure by on average about 3.6 millimeters of mercury. And again, these discrepancies can have a massive effect on your health. And just like the example I gave with a patient before, you know, if it's overestimating your blood pressure, it may even lead to an incorrect diagnosis of hypertension, or it might even miss you from being diagnosed with hypertension and being treated and reducing your cardiovascular risk. So to avoid this, it is essential that you make sure that the blood pressure cuff that you are using is the right size. And here's basically what you need to do. So to make sure you're using the right blood pressure monitor, you're gonna need one of these, just a simple tape measure, okay? What we're gonna do is we're gonna first find our acronium process. It's just the bony bit here, just where your shoulder is, and measure it down all the way to your elbow, basically the bony bit. Medical term for this is olecranon process. So once you've got that measurement, divide it in two basically, and that's your midpoint, all right? So you found your midpoint now, and then wrap your measuring tape around your bicep basically at the midpoint, and that is your arm circumference. Now I know that my arm circumference is 12.5 inch, So we're going to bring up the A&D Medical cuff size chart now on screen. So as you can see, looking at the chart, it's quite clear that basically the standard adult wide range cuff that comes with most of our A&D Medical blood pressure monitors is going to fit my arm. It's from 8.6 to 16.5 inch, so I fit it perfectly. Now looking at our arm circumference chart I'm looking at right now, basically the small adult, the standard wide range adult, medium adult, and large adult cuffs, they will all fit most of our A&D Medical blood pressure monitors. However, if you do need the extra large cuff, which is the UA282A cuff, this one is only compatible with the UA789AC model. It's just good for you to know that in case you do have to order the extra large cuff, so you know you need to get the compatible device for it. Moving straight on to tip number three. How long have you had your blood pressure monitor for? Because over time, wear and tear can affect its performance. And it's also important to make sure that your cuff isn't leaking air, because sometimes they can do that. And unfortunately, many blood pressure monitors don't actually have a sensor that detects any cuff leak. Now, the good news is here at A&D Medical, we've actually built in this technology in our Precision Check Pro device, which is in my hand. This is one of the reasons why I love A&D Medical so much, because we're at the forefront of bringing new innovations to all our medical products. This particular model, it features dual sensor pressure verification and precision cuff leak detection to help you get the most accurate results possible. Oh, and best of all of our A&D Medical blood pressure monitors come with a 5-year warranty if you're in the UK, USA or Canada. But believe me, when it comes to blood pressure monitors, A&D Medical blood pressure monitors are an absolute workhorse. I've been using them in my own clinical practice for years. Quick outfit change. I've taken off my white coat so we can go on to tip number four, and it's all about cuff placement. Because if it isn't positioned correctly, you're not gonna get accurate results from your blood pressure monitor. So here is the best way to put your blood pressure cuff on. I always tell patients, first, just put it on here. Put your arm out straight, all right, palm facing up. Next, we're gonna pull our cuff up just onto the bicep, and we're basically gonna put it two fingers above where your elbow bends, all right? So that's the correct placement. And then notice this white dot, okay? All of our A&D Medical blood pressure monitors have this white dot. This should be aligned with your middle finger, okay? So this is in the correct position right now. With two fingers up, basically from our elbow, correct again. And I'm gonna close it just so it's tight enough so I can just about fit two fingers in there, all right? We need it to be nice and snug, not too tight and not too loose that we're able to fit 3-4 fingers in, okay? That is the correct position now. Now, I just wanna tell you about a common mistake that I see a lot of patients making, and I've seen it quite often. I have discussed it in our other videos as well. But quite often I see patients putting on their blood pressure monitor the wrong way around, okay? So remember, this white dot should always be facing down, so down the arm. But often I see patients trying to put on a blood pressure cuff the complete wrong way around, okay? So please be aware of this, that you're not doing it. It's actually really difficult to close as well. So I'm actually having to do it the other way around to try and close. But if you're ever doing, you know, closing your blood pressure cuff like this and your hose is running upwards, for example, and this white dot is up here, this is incorrect, right? It's going to give us massively wrong readings, okay? So please make sure you are wearing your cuff the right way around as well, as it's a very common issue I see with patients. Now, whilst we're on the topic of blood pressure cuffs and making sure that they fit correctly and it's placed correctly, most of our blood pressure monitors here at A&D Medical have what we call advanced cuff fit detection, all right? So the monitor is able to realize if it's not fitting properly your blood pressure cuff, and this symbol is going to pop up on screen. This will pop up on your monitor to basically indicate that there's something just not right about this fit. And again, the beauty of this is it's going to make sure that we're getting accurate readings every time. The next tip I want to discuss about making sure you're getting the most accurate readings from your blood pressure monitor is temperature. Temperature is something a lot of people, patients, and medical providers are not talking about enough when it comes to taking your blood pressure. Believe it or not, your ambient room temperature can have an effect on the blood pressure readings you're taking. If your ambient room temperature is low, so I'd say anything below 21 degrees Celsius, that's about 70 Fahrenheit, If your home is cold, basically we get vasoconstriction happening. Our blood vessels constrict, and it's basically something our body does to conserve heat. When we constrict our blood vessels, our blood pressure goes up. So it's going to give us a higher blood pressure reading. Same applies if your home is really warm. So if it's constantly above 21 degrees, basically your blood pressure, your blood vessels are going to dilate, and that dilation is going to drop our blood pressure. So again, ambient room temperature plays a massive part in our blood pressure reading. So the most important thing is to make sure you have a constant temperature in your home. I always recommend keeping your home at about 21 degrees Celsius on your thermostat. That's about 70 Fahrenheit, okay? So just try and keep your home at a normal temperature. Now again, I just want to tell you another fantastic feature about our A&D Medical Precision Check Pro device, the one in my hand. At A&D Medical, we were the inventors of the blood pressure monitor, the digital blood pressure monitor, in 1977, okay? So we're always at the forefront of bringing new features on our devices. This device in my hand also takes the ambient room temperature with every blood pressure reading that you take. The beauty of that is if you've got an outlier on one of your blood pressure readings, for example, you've always got the temperature of the room at the time. So you might be able to find the correlation at times, and it's just great data to have. And by the way, if you want to see this experiment, because we've actually done this experiment, taking my blood pressure from a cold environment and also a warm environment and seeing the difference, it's quite incredible. Okay, so please do go on our channel. I will leave a link to it in the description as well to learn more about it, because it's some really interesting science. Straight on to tip number six. Remember that blood pressure fluctuates during the day, so it's always good to take multiple readings throughout the day and then average those readings. Now, I want to talk about a really cool feature on our A&D Medical Precision Check Pro device, the one in my hand. It has something called our trademarked tri-check technology. Some of our other devices and models have this as well. This feature basically automatically takes three blood pressure readings, okay? And you can adjust the interval time between each blood pressure reading. So you can have it 30 seconds, 60 seconds, and 120 seconds. I always recommend doing the 60 second one, so 1 minute apart between each three reading, and then the tri-check technology then averages the readings and saves it for you on your blood pressure monitor. And by the way, this aligns with the American Heart Association's blood pressure taking guidelines. You can also sync our Bluetooth enabled A&D Medical blood pressure monitors and other devices actually to our A&D Heart Track app. That way these results are automatically synced on the app, and you can see readings and progression over time. And also you can share them with your medical provider, so it makes life a lot easier for you and your medical provider. Tip number seven, taking your blood pressure correctly. I have seen so many mistakes over the years that I see patients making, and even medical providers making, when they're taking blood pressure readings. We do have in-depth videos on our channel going through step-by-step procedures on picking the right cuff size, on wearing your cuff correctly, on taking your blood pressure correctly, going through it in a lot of detail. So I'd highly recommend watching those videos on the channel. I will link them in the description as well. But here's a quick summary as well that I'm gonna give in this video. So what we've done here is I'm showing you an example of me taking my blood pressure. I'm just doing a voiceover. So first of all, the 30-minute rule has been followed. So that means no eating, smoking, caffeine, or exercise 30 minutes before taking your blood pressure, as these activities can temporarily raise your blood pressure. Next, I want to talk about relaxation. You can see I'm sat in a calm position. My back is supported. My feet are flat on the floor. I've already gone for a bathroom break. I don't need to go to the bathroom. And you can see the cuff is placed correctly. It's two fingers width above my elbow. It's tight enough that I can fit just about two fingertips in there, and the cuff is at heart level, and my arms are fully supported on the table. And most importantly, before you take your blood pressure, no chewing, no talking, no moving, just relax and then press the start button. Easy as that. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really do hope you found this information helpful. As I mentioned before, on our channel we have loads of in-house A&D medical videos made all about cardiovascular related topics, how to lower your blood pressure naturally, looking at different mistakes and how they actually affect your blood pressure, putting them to the test. We have loads of videos that you might find helpful. If you found this video helpful today, please do share it to a friend or anyone that you know will find it helpful as well. And as we say at the end of every single week's video, A&D Medical, discover precision.